Hello and welcome to the video by Productivity Spot. I'm Sumit Bansal and in this video I will show you how to freeze cells and rows and columns in Google Sheets. Here I have this data set where I have the headers and the data, and if I scroll down you can see that the headers disappear. Similarly, if I scroll to the right the data would disappear. Now if you are working with a large data set you may want these headers to always be visible, because if I go down I don't know what column C represents or column E represents, and in this case I may want the first row to be frozen. So to do that, the easiest way is using the mouse drag and drop technique. Simply go to the top left part of the worksheet. Here you see this gray empty box with two thick lines to the right end at the bottom of it. Simply hover your mouse over that line. You'll see this hand icon. Left click and drag it down. And when you do this, you can see this thick line. And just drop it below the row till which you want the worksheet to be frozen. In this case, I want the first row freezed. So I would simply drop it here. And now when I scroll down, you can see that the first row is always available, always visible. Similarly, I can come here. When I see the hand icon, I can drag it to the right and drop it where I want those columns to always be visible. Similarly, if I go to the right, you can see that these columns are always visible and these rows are always visible. If you want to change it again, simply come here. When you see the hand icon, you can change it and you can bring it back if you want the default setting. So here, let me bring it back. So this is one way of doing it. It's definitely the fastest way, but it's not the only way. You can also use the settings in the tabs here. So in case you want to freeze the first row, you go to view. And within view in freeze, you can say you want to freeze one row and that will be the first row. So if I click this, you can see that this line has automatically changed and the first row is now frozen. Similarly, if I go back here again and I say two rows, then it will freeze two rows. If you want a custom number, so in this case, let's say you want to freeze five rows, then you click the fifth row here. Go to view, freeze, and then you go to up to current row. That would be five. And if I select this, it'll freeze five rows here. Similarly, you can use the same technique for freezing the columns. You go to view, freeze, and then you can specify one column, two column, or select a column number, a column, and go here again and say up to current column, which is column number F. And if you want to unfreeze these, simply go back here and say no rows and no columns, and that will bring you to the default setting. So these are the two ways you can use in Google Sheets to freeze rows and columns. That's it in this video. I hope you found this useful. Thank you and have a nice day.